we are now sat at the bar.
Already.
Ready to get the cocktails.
Getting our drinks packages.
Yeah. Which has just cost us
£250 each for 5 days for a drinks packet.
5 days?
But
Starbucks.
We've not seen a lot, have we? We don't really know how to get about the ship, we keep getting lost.
We've just decided alcohol is priority.
We stumbled upon a bar and a jacuzzi, so that'll do us. But if you look round, there's an outdoor pool and on each side a jacuzzi. Oh, exciting! And tonight we are going to see Beverly Knight.
Yes.
Kerry Ellis.
And we're going to the nightclub later.
And Kerry Ellis and then the nightclub and a casino.
Yeah, well, it's
going to
be a late one.
Who were the two girls, the two women that were in front of us that I was talking to about? They'd already got selfies with two of the
stars of the shows.
Ah, how? Yeah. Where'd they seen them?
In the lift with us.
Well, but they don't.
We got in the lift as we got out.
So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome here on the stage, John Alan Jones.
Navigator of the Seas.
And we've already had quite a few claims to fame, haven't we?
We have. We've met. Who have we met? Lee Mead, Beverly Knight.
Bobby Davro. Wants to meet Kelly Ellis. I want to meet Calabro. I did the Lee Mead. It was quite embarrassing. I was really starstruck, wasn't I? But
we met some guy who was playing piano in a lift. Neither of us have been on a cruise before. So I don't know what we're more amazed by, the actual ship or the musical theatre stuff. I was going to do a walk around of the ship, but it's too big and I'll get lost. So you're not getting a walk around the ship, but I will tell you when we get off in Amsterdam, anything that you see that's not in Amsterdam is on the boat. So you can marvel at that in your own ways. And today we have Lee Mead, Christina Bianco and Kerry Ellis again.
And we've just missed the leads of Jersey Boys this morning, who I wanted to see, Ben.
We're going to get some lunch.
We're going to get some lunch,
yeah. And then we're going to watch Showstopper, which is an improvised musical.
Something for Mrs. Harris.
Yes.
Now, what set? I'm not a fan of. I don't often go to Ann Summers. I'm a big fan of Ann Summers, but I don't often go. What section of Ann Summers is here? Something kind of fun that's made up, if you want to. Where?
The vibrator.
It is, however, a matinee. So to help us keep our lunch down, can I have something that's just imaginative and fun, but not actually just filthy? What's that? Again?
Lace.
Did you say lace? Rubber handcuffs. Okay, I answer that. Rubber handcuffs. It's the handcuffs section that he's in. As you know, Claire, Mrs. Harold used to be a police officer.
Yes. I just like to control you, Harold. I often want to open up your more free-willing side for you.
That's very kind of you, Claire. I must say the display is rather intimidating, isn't it?
Come get looked at with your loved ones.
Yes, we brought some new animatronics in the hope of, well, clamping people down.
It's so much fun, it's criminal.
I've often wished that Mrs. Harold might, you know, allow us to explore softer, happier, sweeter territory.
You'll be swell when you think of yourself in a cell.
But she dresses up in her uniform and I have to wear a black and white t-shirt and a bag marked swag and pretend to be a 1950s robber.
And she explains about the inner beast in this number that could come from the producers.
You a thing or two, I could show you what's inside of you. If you want to express yourself, just get off of that vacillating violet shelf. Open up the doors and show the world what you've got.
That's enough. Back to the story.
I know Marjorie is in love with me. Do you think it's a terrible thing? I mean, she's come in here, but we're selling so much more than we would do if she wasn't in love with me.
Well, maybe you just need to make her think you're in love with her. Do you follow me?
Yes.
I was concerned, but maybe I wasn't clear enough. It's a very simple plan.
Do you think you married a fool, Wendy?
What?
What?
I'm sorry, I just said last thing you said.
I said, did you think you married a fool?
Oh, no, I didn't think I married a fool. We're married!
Honestly, how could you forget? And it's our anniversary. But I think it's a very good idea. I'd still make a fool in love with you.
To watch Showstopper.
So funny.
So good. It's like an improvised musical, so they make everything up on the spot. I think it's me on the West End, and it's had loads of awards and stuff. So they take suggestions from the audience, and then they devise a musical around it. So today they got Anne Summers, so we got an hour and a half musical based around the storyline in Anne Summers. And then they ask you what style they want the songs in, like styles of what musical. How rude.
Gorgeous bikini.
On our tangent now. Uh-huh. The announcement's over. I can't even remember what we were talking about.
We were talking about Anne Summers.
Anne Summers, and then they did the songs in the style of, they got suggested Chicago, Producers and Hamilton. Then Mother and Alf went. I was a bit worried when they were on that top deck, and then the suggestion was Anne Summers.
Yeah.
But Al said it was one of the best things he's ever seen. But on the pool deck, waiting for an outdoor showing of The Greatest Showman, cool. If you wanted to, you could literally sit in a hot tub with a cocktail watching The Greatest Showman.
Yeah.
It's really cool. Look. So there's the bar, there's the pool, and then the show gets shown on that big screen up there.
I was a girl of just a few words, laying in the sun, just a little kid chasing bluebirds and singing just for fun.
Let's move on to our next performer. Now, he shot to fame winning Andrew Lloyd Webber's Any Dream Will Do, and he's had an illustrious musical theatre career, starring in musicals like Wicked, to Joseph, and many more in between. So ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honour to bring on this gentleman. Please, let's start putting those hands together. And welcome to the stage, Lee Mee!
You enjoy yourselves?
Yes!
I hope you enjoy this set. It's a lovely song to me, I'm sure.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
Sky, I wanna
trying to guess, we are in Amsterdam now. This is not the cruise ship. So we got up stupidly early this morning. We were up at like 6 o'clock to have breakfast, and then the ship had only docked at 6 o'clock, even though it was docked at 7, so it was a mad rush to get off. But we have to be back on the ship by, I want to say 4, so we don't actually have that long to do stuff. So I don't really know what our plan is from here, but I thought I should clarify that this is not the ship. Just, you know, just in case you didn't know. I would hope that you would. I would hope no one is that dim, but I did say I would do it, so I did. I'm going to give you an intimate look into the world of Suzanne.
Hi, I'm back. Seems like got over there. Just now you can be seen, could you believe? Look, we've got a Primark. Are we going in? Hoping, yeah, we're going to go into Primark, saying it's going to close. And further down the road, there's McDonald's and KFC. And we've seen Starbucks as well, haven't we? So we should just like walking around Doncaster.
Did you just say it's just like walking around Doncaster, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, they're in different cities. Oh, CNA! How ancient is that?
That's our ship.
That our ship?
Yeah. Oh, so you don't want to go to the other side. The ferries are for free, so don't start to buy a ticket for it. Dit is gewoon even kijken naar de nieuwe veren. Die veren zitten hier op ons hand. Maar dat is dan nog niet. It's amazing how many people buying tickets for the GVB, buying tickets for trams and buses and not for the ferry.
It's massive, isn't it?
Yeah. So we've got to go for GVB, is that's for the last one.
We're nearly at the end of our trip. We're nearly at the end of our day.
Yeah, we had a bit of a boat trip, didn't we?
Yeah, like I said, didn't really get long.
Well, now I'm home.
We are. By the look of it, we're going to drive straight past our ferry. Drive, sail.
Our ferry. Our ship.
And it's huge. So you don't really, when you're in it, you know it's big, but then when you see it from the outside, you realise just how big, don't you? We're
going
to collide with it. Do you just ask if we get off here? So he was having to walk all the way back down. Look, you can see it. You can't see it, alive.
But we're heading straight for it.
We are.
Head on collision, I think this boat was like...
Yeah. But we haven't really done a lot, have we? We spent a lot of the day shopping.
No, I've spent up, wasted 40 quid.
Now you've got nothing to show for it.
She got a raft.
I got a raft. I got a new foundation. And a new foundation. And I got some...
Oh, you went lost your foundation, have you? Now I lost a 40 euro mascara. Givenchy.
There we are, I can see it out the window. There's our ship. Where all the little portholes are at the front, that's all the dining room. The dining room goes onto 3 different floors.
I'm never going back. The past is in the past.
9 on our last day, which is very sad. I feel so awkward vlogging when there's lots of passers-by. Yeah, so last day, very sad about it. You know what else I'm really sad about, but also happy? It's been so good that I just have so much footage to use for this video, and I'm gonna be editing for hours of my life. But I just wanted to show you this because it looks beautiful. I feel like, I don't know, like obviously I've been on boats before, as you guys will see from cost vlogs, many boat trips, but this is like an entirely different feel. Yeah, so it's 9:30. I'm just about to head down for a Q&A with Michael Ball, which I'm also very excited about. I'm so honoured this morning. I feel really proud of myself because I got up at 7, went for breakfast, packed my case already, had several coffees, and it's 10 o'clock and I get to go sit in a room with Michael Ball answering questions.
Come up, you do the two shows, kind of like we did, and then there'll be a reception afterwards, and then in the morning, with Princess Anne, you'll be there, and we'll launch the ship. Wow. So the shows went great, lovely, lovely reception afterwards, really lovely,
bit like
almost legendary, and I woke up. Oh, bloody hell, what time is it? I looked out the window and an elephant, I'm not joking, an elephant is walking past and a parade starts going past my window and there's Princess Anne on the podium giving it some... I've missed the... And just to prove it's true though, these things happen, the champagne didn't break. And it went out on its maiden voyage and it broke down. We had to tow it back. True story. So I'm... That's a shocker, isn't it? Oh.
So, went to the Michael Ball's Q&A, which is actually really good, really interesting. And... now I'm waiting to be taught to dance by the guy from Blood Brothers. I cannot dance. Barely know Blood Brothers as a musical, to be honest, but we're gonna go. We're gonna give it a go, see what happens. And then we've got an hour's gap to get changed for the evening. Everything's so like crammed together, but everyone still like wants to get dressed up for the evening, so you end up getting dressed up for the evening whenever you've got a gap. And today my gap is at like 4 o'clock. So I'm going to spend all of that time in the different activities, dressed up, ready for the evening. But take what you can get in it. So we're going to dance from 2 to 3, get changed at 3. 4 o'clock we're going to like a guest that tune thing with the Piano Lift Guideliner Show, which is collaborating. Then we're going to go see Christina Bianco again, and then we're going to go see Bobby Davro doing his like comedy and crooners act. So got quite a full last day. I filmed to show you guys, but so every night he's been like in different lifts, and the lift will just arrive, it'll open, and he'll be there singing and playing piano. And as you get in, he'll ask you what songs, what show you want to sing with him, and then he'll play basically what you ask him to play and he'll sing with you. And of all, like, obviously we've got these massive like headliner acts, like we have Michael Ball, we've got Johnny Jones, we've had Christina Bianco. Collaborate tonight, of all of them, my favourite part of the whole cruise has been getting in that lift. To the point where I was in karaoke the other night and I had my song on the list waiting to go, and then I heard the lift open, I heard the piano coming from, I literally ran through the karaoke room to the lift to catch a lift, and then just went up and down and then missed my song, but she put me in at the end and everyone else had guessed where I'd been, they guessed that I'd be running up and down the lift, so sorting really, but he is. It's just fun, isn't it? Just to give you a feel of how big the ship is. So I'm here with Suzanne, mum, and my mum, and my mum's boyfriend, friend, partner, whatever they're labelling themselves as. And so me and Suzanne are in the same room, and mum and Alpha are in the same room. We're both on the same like time schedules, so we go for dinner at the same time, we go to all the shows at the same time, and I've not seen them for 2 days. I don't know where they are. They may not even still be on the ship, they may have got lost in Amsterdam somewhere. But yeah, 48 hours I've not seen them, even though we are on the same ship doing all the same things. That is how big everything is. I even tried to knock on the room to find them and they weren't in there. And then I went down to all the bars that they normally go to, they weren't there. And then at dinner, I was like, surely I'll see them. Nope.
I don't want to sing it out loud. perfect. So let's just try that bit with the music if we can, Helen. Is it possible? That's the chorus.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Collaborate.
Not just as singers, but as businessmen, because it takes, what we didn't realise at the time, was a massive amount of time and effort to release a major UK album. And we ended up getting into the top 10 with it. It was the highest release by an independent label of that year. And the reason why we're incredibly proud of that album is because we got to do this next song, one of the reasons, of which there are many, but this one is really the top one. Because we've always dedicated songs to the audience, or to family, or to friends, or you know, so on and so forth. We never got to do a song for each other. And we wanted to mark the fact that we were doing an album all by ourselves, all of the marketing, the production, the creative, everything we did, and we oversaw. And that was so special to us that we wanted to dedicate a song to each other. And we searched and researched and researched. Has anyone heard of the musical Wicked? Yeah. Well, this song is for good.
It's really stressful. We're not actually in the middle.
Come on. I've heard it said people come into our lives for a reason. They'll be back, bringing something we must learn, and we are glad to those who help us most to grow if we let them fall. Because I knew you. Because.